This video is part one of a two-part piano tutorial on Chopin's Etude, Opus 10, number one. In this video, we look together at four new progressive exercises composed especially for this tutorial, made in collaboration with the composer and arranger, Mercuzio. These new exercises are a distillation of sorts of what is, in my view, the technical essence of the etude, arranged in such a way as to benefit both intermediary and advanced pianists. These exercises can be downloaded from a link in the video information. There are several differences in the published editions. Friedheim, von Bülow, Mikuli, Korto and others differ as to which notes should be played in the following bars. Personal preference is to play the B-flat instead of the A in bar 5 and the B-flat instead of the C in bar 29. But it's for you, of course, to decide which notation you wish to play. See how far you can pass notes using each of your five fingers without losing contact with the keyboard. I can make 19 notes, but many of you will be able to do more. Then test the widest interval you can make between fingers 1 and 2. Two and four. And four and five. When the arpeggios are arranged in one octave triplets back and forth, we learn the variety of intervals and how they feel when played in legato without pedal to our own hands in a stretch. In exercise one, we practice passing the bottom notes smoothly to the top, way beyond the reach of our fully outstretched hand, by slightly turning the wrist, which we keep light and relaxed at all times. Thank you. Exercise 2 is a new arrangement made for this tutorial of the etude based on Bach's Prelude No. 1, Book 1 of the Well-Tempered Clavier. And it's important to use the same fingering for this exercise as you will use later in the etude throughout. Exercise 3 is a reduction of the etude from 4 octaves down to 2. Playing just 2 octaves makes repeated practice more comfortable for the right arm being concentrated around the lower treble. This exercise can also be thought of as confidence building, as it just seems so much more accessible than the original etude, even though the technical demands to play both are actually quite similar. Aim to practice smoothly, quietly, with a feeling of muscular relaxation from fingertips right through your arms to your shoulders. Thank you. When you feel ready, add the expression and dynamic contrast while still keeping the same feeling of flexibility in the hands and arms. At some point, take time for careful, concentrated, slow legato practice. The slower you practice, the more your fingers stay momentarily in the shapes of the intervals made by the inner stretch of your hand. This helps muscle memory as well as expand your hand's inner stretch. Practice making equal touch and volume for each finger. In exercise 4, the arpeggios have a harmonic interval between the bottom and top note. We connect the bottom and top notes of each group of four by supporting the turning wrist on the finger playing the third note of the group of four. And this is mirrored going down. That's to say, the third note of the group of four is essentially a pivot note for the turning wrist. In the follow-on video, part two of this tutorial, we move from the study to the performance, and it's linked in the video information. Many thanks to Mercuzio for all his help and wonderful arrangements. His channel is similarly linked below. Mercuzio and I hope you will find these exercises featured in this video both technically and musically rewarding. Thanks for watching.